Good morning, friends, and welcome as we prepare to celebrate the fifth Sunday of Ordinary Time. I invite each of us to really enter into this Mass in recognizing that we speak to God in prayer. Jesus, the divine healer, wishes to touch your soul with his grace at this very Eucharist. So just with the same passion as we would to watch our kids playing sports or cheer on our favorite team, let us worship God, not mumbling responses or perhaps not even responding at all, but recognizing that heaven and earth are united at this Mass. And so with great joy and the honor and privilege to speak to the King of Kings, let us stand together and join in our opening hymn. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather at this Mass in praise and worship of God, our divine physician, we are honored and privileged to be able to be in his presence. And so, with great humility, we enter into this sacred liturgy. At this Mass, we pray in a special way for the repose of the souls of Pietro Tedesco and Innocenzo Ferraro, and the special intention for Mitch and Mary Loic. For the times in which we have find life difficult and fail to reach out our hand, to place our hand in the hand of God, who wishes to heal us and lift us up, we bow our heads and ask for God's mercy, for he is full of gentleness and compassion. You raise the dead to life in the spirit. Lord, have mercy. You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light to those who are in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sin and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Job. Job spoke to his friends, "Does not the human being have a hard service on earth, and are not their days like the days of a laborer? Like a slave who longs for the chattels, and like a laborer who looks for the wages. So I am allotted months of emptiness, and nights of misery are apportioned to me. When I lie down, I said, when shall I rise? But the night is long, and I am full of tossing until dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's chattel, and come to their end without hope. Remember that my life is a breath. My eye will never again see good." The word of the Lord. Reading from the first letter of St. Paul of the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if I proclaim the gospel, this gives me no ground for boasting, for an obligation is laying on me. And woe to me if I do not proclaim the gospel. For if I do this of my own will, I have a reward. But if not of my own will, I am entrusted with a commission. What then is my reward? Just this, that in my proclamation I may make the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my rights in the gospel. For though I am free with respect to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so that I might win more of them. To the weak I became weak, so that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all people, that I might by all means save some. I do it all for the sake of the gospel, so that I may share in its blessings. The word of the Lord.
Took our infirmities and bore our diseases.
Alleluia.
Brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
As soon as Jesus and his disciples left the synagogue, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they told Jesus about her at once. He came and took her by the hand and lifted her up. Then the fever left her, and she began to serve them. That evening at sunset, they brought to Jesus all who were sick or possessed with demons, and the whole city gathered around the door. And he cured many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. In the morning, while it was still very dark, Jesus got up and went to a deserted place, and there he prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for him. When they found him, they said to him, "Everyone is searching for you." He answered, "Let us go on to the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also, for that is what I came out to do." And Jesus went throughout Galilee, proclaiming the message in their synagogues and casting out demons. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
My brothers and sisters, the church gives us these readings that build on last week, which talk about casting all our anxieties, distresses, and concerns upon Jesus. We know that Jesus is the divine physician. He is the only one who can help us. Our issues of physical, emotional, spiritual, economic, The list goes on and on. He is the source of all healing. And in the first reading from Job, we see that, contrary to what Forrest Gump might say, life isn't a box of chocolates. Sometimes life is very difficult. And the church has given us these readings the last 2 weeks to reflect upon how I react when life is difficult. Yohander proclaimed for us that Job is at the point of despair. The night, he can't even get restful sleep. He's dealing with loss in his family, losing most of his wealth, his circle of friends, his social network. He's at the point of despair and calls out to God. What is God's response to Job? What is God's response to us? In the gospel, we see that Jesus responds to need over and over and over again. We see that Jesus was obviously a really nice guy. Why is that, Father Rico? Well, who's the person that he heals in the gospel? Simon's mother-in-law. Why do we always pick on mother-in-laws? I was told at a wedding, Father Rico, you don't understand because you don't have one. I don't know that that's true. Well, it is true that I don't have a mother-in-law, but why we pick on them, I have no clue. But nonetheless, Jesus does something extremely beautiful for her. She's in bed with a fever and would likely die from it had Jesus not responded. And so what does Jesus do? He takes her by the hand and he lifts her up. Jesus takes her by the hand and lifts her up. He doesn't speak to her. He doesn't tell others to do things. He silently, gently, and beautifully brings healing to this woman in need. How does Jesus, the divine physician, deal with us in our need? Does he not respond in the same gentle, beautiful, and tender way? No matter what our needs are, as I said, physical, emotional, psychological, spiritual, financial, whatever our needs are, God's hand is always ready, reaching out to us, ready to take our hand and to lift us up. But he humbles himself so much that he waits for our action. Like the calling out of Job, the Lord responds and blesses him for his righteousness. If we but call out to him, the Lord will do the same for us as he takes us by the hand and lifts us up. We are never alone. We are never forgotten or cast aside. The people who witnessed Jesus' profound love for Simon Peter's mother-in-law were amazed. Are we amazed at how God works through our daily lives? Or do we just take God for granted? Are we too proud to reach out our hand? Or we seek the hand of others. But nobody can heal like the divine physician can heal. The only hand I want to hold is the hand of the Messiah. Just as a young child, when they are afraid, troubled, or in trouble, seeks the hand of their parent, a grandparent, an older sibling, or someone they trust, perhaps a teacher, a coach, somebody to that effect. So much more should our longing be to reach out and grab the hand of Jesus, who wishes to hold us and to lift us up. Jesus invites us, even as we enter into prayer, friends, with the beautiful words of the Lord's Prayer. There's three powerful elements in the Lord's Prayer that speak of God's daily, precious, compassionate, and caring nature for you. Number one, give us this day our daily bread. That our appeal to God can be daily, better be daily. If I am not praying the Lord's Prayer at least once a day, then I have wasted the day. 24 hours, I am far from God. Good luck, Father Rico. Give us this day our daily bread. God is interested in our lives today on February the 7th. He was interested in our lives every day prior to the 7th and every day after the 7th, but he's interested in our feelings, our emotions, wherever we find ourselves in the now. And he tells us to ask God for what we need, to stretch out our hand and ask, never to be afraid, never to be afraid. Element number two. Forgive us as we forgive others. If we want to be healed, we must take on forgiveness. The more we push it off, the more we think that this person who's hurt us, this group of people, or the situation that has hurt us, need not deserve our forgiveness. The wound remains open. Infection comes in. We fall into other traps of sin. We become resentful or angry. We hold grudges, create divisions. That's not what the Lord's Prayer is all about. That's not what taking the hand of Jesus is all about. Forgive us as we forgive others. We want to be happy. We want to be healed. We need to forgive. Jesus knows he was there. We need not find justification from anyone else. But he who is the divine physician. Come to me, all you who are labored and find life burdensome. I will refresh you, says the Lord. And then finally, lead us not into temptation. How many of us are shackled in sin? How many of us are addicted to things that are holding us back from the holy person God is calling us to be? We are on the brink of the holy season of Lent, one of the most powerful seasons of our liturgical year, to help us to enter into true conversion. Lord, I need to be healed of my porn addiction. Lord, my language is not appropriate. I'm addicted to work. I'm so lazy. I'm not providing for my family in whatever capacity as I should. Lord, I don't pray enough. Lord, I take you for granted. Even when I attend Mass, I just sit there and listen and zone out, thinking about the Super Bowl, thinking about other stuff. Friends, we need to realize that in prayer, we are speaking to the King of Kings, who deserves our utmost respect, and even when we cast him aside, reaches out our hand and calls you by name and wishes to free you from those shackles of sin, wishes to help you to become a holy person, who wants to flood your heart with his grace, his love, and his mercy. And yet he continues to patiently wait with arm outstretched, waiting to take our hand and to lift us up. When we are close to God, we are happy. Doesn't mean our lives are perfect. But the more I trust in God, the more I realize Jesus has my back. What should I be afraid of? Death, sickness, division, dysfunction, loss of employment, uncertainty in academics, loss of a social life, None of this stuff will hold any water if I trust that my hand is wrapped patiently, beautifully, and tightly with that of my Messiah, who wishes to lift us up. Why are we reluctant to allow Jesus to heal us? If we do it our way, it's going to be harder. The more we push Jesus aside, the more the difficulties come. And yet he continues to push past our obstacles and our barriers, and he reaches out his hand. Take my hand. I love you. I want to heal you. I want to remove those shackles. I want to transform your life. I want to flood your soul with my grace. I love you more than you will ever understand. This is how Jesus speaks to us. Do we believe this? That the King of creation thinks enough of you to stop whatever he's doing and to focus on your need? The proof is in the pudding of the scriptures, friends. Over and over and over again, God is revealed to us as a divine healer. And our need for conversion is immediate. We cannot afford to wait another day without grasping the hand of Jesus. For without God, nothing is possible. But with him, all things are possible. Father Rico, this sounds great, but what does it mean for me? Friends, you have to make a personal decision for an inner conversion of your heart. To not say the words of the Lord's Prayer, but to mean them. That when you enter into Mass, when you enter into your own dialogue with God, are you truly asking for the Lord's hand to touch you? And not being touched on our terms, but his terms. He's the one who's going to lead us to a solution to our problems. He's the one who gives us the divine medicine that we need. He's the one who has a plan for us that has eternity at stake. Nothing that I should decide to do, say, or behave in should defer me from this loving presence of God, who calls us by name and wishes to lift us up. Last week, I took the time to present to us all the trailer of a powerful program that I believe will push us into this conversion that Lent 2021 is calling us to. Many of you have signed up for this program. Many of you have not. Whose hand do you wish to hold, my friends? Jesus is speaking through this sinful priest to you. He's inviting you to put everything aside and to be transformed through this program that the Franciscans have blessed our church with, which screams Holy Spirit, metanoia. So once again, I would like to take the time to show us this beautiful trailer. And as you watch, I want you to focus, not because Father Rico wants you to do this, although Italian Catholic guilt is very effective at times. So if you need that, use it. But rather, that Jesus wants you this Lent, friends, to take his hand so he can lift you up. So let us watch the trailer again and look forward to reaching out to the hand of Jesus.
Whatever we call it, you know, ache, thirst, hunger, you know, there's something just yawning in our chests.
It's this eternal question I have, like, how can I be sure I'm actually saved?
There is only one who's come down from heaven to suffer, to die,
Jesus knows the way to eternal life.
I remember looking at the Eucharist, and I felt like chain-link armor fell from my eyes.
The Lord knew that deep down inside, there was still that ache to follow him, and something inside me changed.
This is a moment of conversion, a moment of grace, a moment of metanoia, that we come to understand the things of this world are ultimately going to leave us empty.
Trinity is revealed in the person of Jesus, and particularly that vision is opened through his passion, death, and his resurrection.
I see him up there on that cross, and that keeps me going.
All that pain and suffering that he had to go through and he had to endure, it's like so he can save me.
Jesus calls us out of this tomb. That's my story and your story. The Lord calls us out of death into life.
I want so much more of God, but I have to give up so much more if I really want it.
The truth is a person. It's not merely a philosophy or an idea. It is a person. And this is important for each one of us because we're going to stand before the Lord and he's going to ask us, who do you say that I am?
Show us who you are, follow where you go.
Jesus' hand is outstretched, waiting to lift you up. Are you ready, as the song tells us, for the Lord to show you who he is? Let us stand together as sons and daughters of God and proudly profess our faith in God, the divine healer, as we use the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sin. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My friends, let us open our hearts in prayer to our Father, who has shown his power to heal through his Son, Jesus. Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray that the church may be continually healed in its human weakness, division, and sinfulness, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for all who are sick or suffering. Let us pray for all health workers who attempt to bring healing, our doctors, nurses, healthcare workers, pastoral caregivers, psychologists, and all who work to restore health to those who are afflicted with illness and disease, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. In this year of celebrating the 175th anniversary of our cathedral church, for the mercy of God to wash over all those who seek healing and forgiveness, as a diocesan family, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for all who are sick, especially Helen Gustau, Velma Zelader, Peter Riley, Francis and Jenny Bozzo, Maria Cipriano, Mary Cardoni, and all who are sick, that they may hear Christ's healing word, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for the healing grace of God, that he may purify those who have died. We pray especially for Sylvia Malvestuto, Judith Harmon, Raphael Porco, Sue Romain, Emma Rye, Mario Di Pietro, Adam Comar, Luigi Giancola, Benny Pizzicarola, Innocenzo Ferraro, and Pietro Tedesco, and all who have died, that God may grant them eternal rest and peace in his kingdom, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. And for all the intentions we verbalize to God amongst the shackles of sin, the areas of our life that we need healing, and all that we verbalize to God from our hearts. God, our divine physician, we know that all health and wholeness comes from you. May we cease to push you away and proudly stretch out our hand so that you may take our hand and lift us up. Heal us of our sicknesses, our divisions, our resentment, our sins, and our frailty. We ask this in all things as we trust in your almighty providence for us. Amen.
Oh Lord, my God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread which we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mingling of this water and wine, we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine which we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord. May our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, of my iniquity. Cleanse me of my many sins. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. O Lord, our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Holy Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and temple of the Holy Spirit, might to the praise of your manifold wisdom be manifest as the Church. And so in company with the choirs of angels we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. At this Mass, we use Eucharistic prayer for Masses and various needs, number 2. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the daily journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son Jesus, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." My Lord and my God. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." My Jesus, mercy. The mystery of faith. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son and our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, in whom you have seated at your right hand. We proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, O Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis our Pope and Gerard our Bishop, with all bishops, priests and deacons, women religious, and your entire people, as we walk in your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ. We remember especially Innocenzo, Pietro, Luigi, and all the dead, whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, O God, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her husband, with the apostles and martyrs, with Job, Saint Paul, Saint Catherine of Alexandria, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sin but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. My brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Turn and offer one another a sign of the Lord's peace. Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father and work of the Holy Spirit, through your death gave life to the world, free us by this your most holy body and blood from all our sins and from all that is evil. Keep us faithful to your commandments, and never let us be parted from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. May the blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. For those at home who are receiving Jesus in a spiritual communion, I invite you to pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Christ I'll stand. Here in the power of Christ we stand.
Let us pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live, that made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us turn to our Blessed Mother as we pray. We fly to thy protection, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin, amen. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Friends, we are days away from the holy season of Lent. Enter into metanoia. Enter into the conversion that the Holy Spirit wishes to give to us. And then let us see the fruits of the divine healer working in our daily lives. Again, how do we sign up, Father Rico? Well, it's in my weekly email. Every Friday I send that out. It's on our website. Easy to follow as well. Also on our parish Facebook page. Please do not email the parish to sign up, friends. You must sign up through the website that is given. Please do so. And then enter into this beautiful Lenten season. What an opportunity of grace that God gives to us. God is awesome. Let us respond by placing our hand in his almighty hand. We have started our St. Francis Way walk. Please continue to pray for me and the other pilgrims who are doing so, as we ask the Holy Spirit to flood this community with his grace and mercy. We also pray for our brothers and sisters who are experiencing Alpha and our RCIA at this time, that are deeply moved as they prepare for this Lenten season and a time of great renewal. Some of our brothers and sisters, for the first time, this will be their first Lent. Let us continue to offer them in prayer. With a beautiful, safe return to school, which has been anticipated for a long time, which I now anticipate will allow us to have more than 10 people at Mass. We look forward to the government making that decision like yesterday. For now, we give thanks and praise to God for the gift of technology. But remember that even though you're watching Father Rico on your television and your devices, it is as if you are in the pews here at Mass. Please enter in and give God the worship that is his due. And for those of us that are signing up for Mass, may our responses come from within, from our heart, as we praise God, not a sports team, not a grandchild playing an activity, not a play or a movie that we watch, but a presence of God who is right here as he lifts us up. What a great joy to worship God. What a privilege it is in this country where we face no persecution, and we do so freely, but it's easy to take for granted. May Lent be a time of true metanoia for us as we turn our hearts to Christ and allow the divine physician to touch us in a compassionate, merciful, and loving way. My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass has ended. Let us go forth in the peace and love of Jesus Christ.
Thanks be to God.
One, two, three, four. You lived, you died, you said in 3 days you would rise, you did. you're alive. You rule, you reign, you said you're coming back again. I know you will, and all the earth will sing your praises. All the earth will sing your praises. Said in 3 days you would rise. You did. You're alive. You rule. You reign. You said you're coming back again. I know you will, and all the earth will sing your praises. You live. You die. You said in 3 days you would rise. You did. You're alive. You rule. You reign. You said you're coming back again. I know you will, and all the earth will sing your praises. All the earth will sing your praises. All the earth will sing your praises.